Hello, everybody. I'm Ahmad Rashad, and welcome to our NBA Inside Stuff 90s reunion. It'll be a rewind look back at all the biggest moments of the decade with all the biggest stars, some of which you can see right here on the screen already. But first, I want to introduce to you my Inside Stuff co-host, one of the greatest people in the world, the most fun I ever had in my entire life, Willow Bay. Willow, how are you?
Come on, I am awesome. How are you? So excited to be back with you all.
I know, this is a lot of fun after all these days, but I guess when the guys come on, they may look a little different because age, time does something. But just talk about the show, how much fun it was. For me, it was one of those things where it was the first time that people got a chance to see these guys off the court and in their homes or shopping or normal, regular kind of stuff. And we were able to go and get them and put them on the show. And we did a show where it was one take. You know, if I messed up, I'd talk myself out of it until we kept going. But it was so much fun every single week with you.
It's true, Ahmad. We laughed so hard some days. It was wild. You know, when I think back, of course, it was like a time of great basketball, great players, great lineups. But what I remember most is the guys and their stories, sharing their stories about what they cared about, what they did off the court, and who they cared about, their families, their countries in so many cases. And that's what I remember the most about it. That laughing so hard, I had tears rolling down my face.
Who's the guy smoking the cigar? That's what I want to know. Who's the guy smoking the cigar on the screen?
Karl Malone is one of the coolest people, has always been one of the coolest people ever. So why would you expect him to change? He's still cool.
Why, you jealous, Reggie?
I am. Because my bosses are looking at this right now. It would be nice. A nice Cohiba, just like light it up right now. But can't do it.
How are you chasing those polar bears through the wilderness after smoking that cigar?
Hey, David, like Ahmad said, we're getting old, so it's a slow roll now.
Hey, I'm with you on that call. That's all I do now, have a nice big cigar and sit back and enjoy life, man. That's what it's about.
So, where are you, Louisiana?
Excuse me?
Where are you, Louisiana?
Yes, ma'am. Louisiana.
God's country.
Oh, my goodness. The Rock is in the building. Mitch Richmond. The Rock. The Rock has joined us.
Hey, this is a great group we got here.
How you doing, Mitch?
It was a lot of stories. How you feel, man?
How you doing, brother?
I can't complain, man. I can't complain. What up, Dave? What up, Mom?
Hey, Mitch, how you doing?
What up, Mitch? Mitch, you know you're a little late. You know that, right?
First of all, let me say something. I was already in. They told me to get out and go.
Oh, well, I'm gonna rescind the fine then, because I had you down here. I had a little fine for you for being late.
Hey, look.
That's all right.
That's what on the floor. Getting dressed for practice, and Clyde was sitting there with us, and Charles said, "Man, what's wrong with your shoe?"
At least let me tell the story. Can I tell the story?
Yes, you can tell the story now. You have
it's
the
go shoot ahead. Around. We're going to shoot around the day of the game, which means there's nobody in the arena, nobody nowhere, right? I put two shoes in my bag, went off to practice. When I got to practice, I realized there were two left shoes.
So, okay.
You need to do one of two things. You cannot practice, or you can put him on and get in a little sweat. So, David, you really have gotten old.
Wow. I knew you should have let me tell the story.
No. I'm going to tell the truth. Look bad, because it's nonsensical. It's a non-story. It really is.
Okay.
Well, hold on. Did you get a little sweat in there?
it was nothing. Well, hold up, Greg. You know me. And you know I don't want to practice anyway. So what do you think?
Oh, man. I swear.
That's a nonsensical story. It's a non-story.
A little something. You had 39 blocks in your career, and you had one against Patrick Ewing. Oh, 7-8-12.
Why you got to bring that up?
I remember it. It was 1993.
Why you got to go there?
Explain it to me. What happened, Pat?
Hey, look, I shot one of those turnarounds, and I waited. I came down too quick. I took too long to release it. Just came from behind and blocked that bad boy.
Oh, shoot.
Right place at the right time. Right place at the right time. You know, Fred always wanted to do that fade. You know, him and Zoe was going, you know, so I had to be at the right place at the right time. Just, you know, kept my hand on it.
What's going on?
Do you remember telling Will and I first on the league that your goal was to dunk on every big man in the league?
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
Absolutely.
You remember that?
I remember that.
And you did do that.
He didn't dunk on me.
Muggsy.
Uh-oh. Oh, we got the footage. Do we have the footage, Ahmad? Do we have the footage?
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean that. I don't watch myself. Did you say that when you were playing with Sean, all that you had to do was just throw it up there anywhere? GP,
can't speak back in here.
You were playing with Sean. You said that all you're gonna do is just throw it up anywhere near the basket.
Oh my God!
He gonna dunk it anywhere, Ma. I'm gonna throw that thing up so high he can go get it, and then he gonna throw out after that.
I'm Berkeley. What's happening? What's up, man?
I got a question. There's different forms of trash talking. I will say this. A lot of people remember that. That's iconic. But there's been so many commercials of this.
No.
Okay. So many questions. Look, that is iconic right here. That's trash talking at its finest. So I'm going to nominate Dikembe Laluki Salapa Nuglaka Niliki Salapa Buruka Tiklaka Mutombo.
Hey, Patrick. Tell me about your rivalry with Indiana.
Hey, look, you just trying to start some ish, boy.
It's supposed to be a reunion, man. Hey,
we broke bread and we good now.
Hey, you know, we in the middle of a pandemic and you want to talk about rivalry. Out all this stuff. In the middle of a pandemic and you want to talk about a rivalry.
Yo.
Well,
come on, I
want
to know about that rivalry.
I will say this. It was fun.
Yes, right? It was.
What
yes,
was funny?
Good time.
And what this, the Jordan Last Dance documentary has shown is 90s, late 80s and 90s basketball was a lot of fun playing against these dudes, man. Because they absolutely prodded every night. So the rivalry was good. It was real. We hated the Knicks. We did hate them. Yes, it was real, but there was a lot of respect there. And that's how I approached it. But it was fun playing against everyone on the screen, man, because they brought it.
Hi.
Yo.
Who is there anybody playing now to remind you of you?
Nope.
Anybody playing now to remind you of you?
No.
No.
Dominique, anybody remind you of you?
You're
over two.
No.
Anybody remind you of you? John Stockton.
Yeah.
Is there any, what?
Giannis Antetokounmpo.
What's up, boy?
Drop the mic, Ahmad, on that question. He dropped the mic on that question. Can't ask any of us that.
I knew.
Good
job, Rob. How
do
you get that nickname?
Oh, man. I think Craig Kilborn gave it to me after I hit a shot actually playing he and Sean Kemp in game 7 and took us into overtime. But, of course, they beat us again. But after that game, I was like, that's when they kind of called me Big Shot. Kind of went from there.
I like that. You may ever block any of your shots?
Of course you did. You did.
Did he do that?
I know he didn't win the championship series.
Yeah, Ron.
And that Jefferson says, when I talk, you know, first eight plays, I said, Shaq, he said he could guard you. I said, first eight plays, call it to you.
Remember that, GB?
Yeah.
Is that Kool-Aid you're drinking, Charles?
Flavored water, brother. Flavored water.
I'm just checking.
That's good, Charles.
Because Shaq on here, you have David on here. These are two guys, that, and even Dikembe. These are two big guys that I had to fight every time we play them. Every time we play these guys, I had to make sure I got my sleep, the right food, because Shaq is big, he's strong. And see, people see Shaq now, they don't realize how, when he first came in, how agile he was. He could get him down the floor. I'd be like, yo, somebody get him. Or even David. David, one of the quickest big men to ever play this game. So, and Dikembe, you know, it is, oh, no, no. You had to make sure you get your rest. You know, I see you asking all these guards and forwards and stuff. But when you had to go against these big boys, in this era, the big guys don't do what we did. You know, they out there shooting threes, and they want to be perimeter guys. In our era, the big guys are stopped. So we had to bring your lunch pail and your hard hat.
I got to tell you something about Patrick. Some of you guys may remember this, but especially when he was the first 5-6 years, he'd be in the front of their press. Front. Not back there blocking shots. Out front. And, you know, guys, we think you're all doing with dribble, right? You could not get around Patrick Ewing with 45 feet. Move those feet, and people just don't understand. That's a big man moving those feet like that. Forget it. So there's nobody like him anymore doing that stuff.
Ahmad, yes, hey, man, sir. I just want to tell you guys, it's been an honor and a pleasure to play against you guys.
Absolutely.
I know most of y'all my adult life, but – I look around my room. I got this Dream Team flag back here from you guys I stole from the Olympics. I got John Stockton over here, jersey on my wall, the mailman. I got, you guys, I just want to thank y'all for giving me a wonderful life. I've been lucky and blessed. I shared it with you guys, so thank y'all for blessing my life, man. And Ahmad, I told you this the other day. You set the blueprint for guys like me who played the game, who went into television. I want to thank you because I signed with NBC. I told you, I came into TV because of you, man. So thank you for giving me this amazing life. And I love all you brothers. Carl, let's get together and smoke some cigars, man.
Anytime you want them, I got you, baby.
Hey. Yeah, I just got to echo what Carl said.
Smoke them if you got them, man. If you don't have them, get them.
All right.
Go ahead,
that's right. That's right. Kakar and I got something real cool for you coming out pretty soon. We can't talk about it right now, but we're going to let y'all know.
Legend.
David, you were going to say something?
No, I was just going to say, man, it's amazing to be part of this fraternity. And, you know, my biggest regret is that I really didn't take the time to get to know you guys better as we were playing. I get to see you guys here and there now. But, man, I got a tremendous amount of respect for everybody. And man, thanks for an amazing 25 years or so, man. Y'all have been amazing. Thank you.
And Dave, I want to say I apologize for making up that rumor. That you love you, brother.
Hold on. What was the rumor?
Hey, Shaq got people in San Antonio mad at me because I didn't sign an autograph for him when he was a kid or something. I don't know.
Remember that. He said he was mad. Saying that, Shaq.
So David took all my shine when he came to San Antonio, so I hated him for that. And then, you know, the first couple of years, he used to kill me, so I had to make up my rumor to get mad. So I could, you know, that's something, because that's just a sprint up and down the court. I used to be like, man, slow down. So I just made up an autograph, you know, made up a scenario. Oh, yeah, when I was 13, you ain't signed my autograph. I'm mad now. So.
You just made it up?
Yeah. Man, we were on the Olympic team. We were sitting on the plane together, and I said, Shaq, man, what is this stuff about, you know, me not signing some autograph? He was like, man, I'm sorry about that. I made that up. I'm
like, hey, Ahmad.
What's wrong with you, bro?
Hey, look, I want to say this. I want to say this. Number one, I want to say to everybody here, you guys, Stock, you know what I think about you, brother. You know I love you to death. You know that. But all the other guys here, you guys brought out the best in us. You guys brought us the best in the Utah Jazz and myself. So I'm grateful for you guys, man. You guys made me the player I was, continue to push me. I know I had to have my A game all the time. And also I need to say this to everybody here. And me and Stock been talking a lot here recently. Hey, our Coach Sloan is not doing well. So I want you guys to pray for Coach Sloan. It is a small fraternity, but I want to tell each and every one of you brothers on this panel right now, if you guys ever need me for anything, bro, I'm there, drop of a hat. Mitch, bro, we're thinking about you, man. We understand your hardship. You understand that. Love you guys, man. And I'm just a phone call away. Y'all made me the player I am. And also, to our frontline health workers, they are our heroes. They have done it every night, and I know we know somebody. So, guys, I'm truly grateful to be on here, but I'm truly grateful for you guys, man. I love all of you guys. Thank you, guys. And I'm like David. I wish I would have took the time to get to know you guys better. Love you guys, man, and thank you guys for making me the player I am.
No problem, bro. Appreciate it, bro.
Awesome, man. Thank you.
All right, talk to you guys real soon, man. Let's do this more often.
Hold on. John, go ahead.
Well, I said, kind of the same thing. This was the greatest time in my life, fellas, you know, playing against you guys. And it's funny, I hate you and love you at the same time. And it's when we were playing, and now that we're older and mature, I mean, Gary and I, you know, it's the relationships that David, the chances we've had to be together afterwards, Clyde, there's just nothing like it in my life. There's no comparison. And I appreciate you guys more than I can possibly say on this thing. And thank you, really, from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Well, I want to say this. Yeah, I'm friends with a lot of y'all. You know, real, real tight with a gang of y'all. Mitch, Clyde, Matumbo, Carl, and y'all know how I feel about John. You know, so he pushed out of me. Shaq is like a brother to me. You know, and then Charles, we all worked together. And when we were playing each other, you guys, you know that we wasn't like this day and era. We didn't get to be around each other. We didn't get to play AU with each other and be friends. We got to know each other on Olympic teams or in the All-Star games, especially with Unique. All of you guys, man, I appreciate all y'all because I looked up to all of y'all. And when I went and played basketball, I wanted to be like y'all. You know, and Glenn, all y'all, we all was together, and we all, the 90s was the greatest basketball ever in my life.
You're right.
I don't care about none of that stuff. These people talking about the 90s basketball was the greatest basketball ever. You know, and I got to know you guys, and I got to be around you guys. It's nothing like this. And this right here today is showing how much we are together because we can get on and act crazy with each other and have fun. And this is what we need to do all the time. And when we see each other, we need to praise each other because it's short. And we all brothers, man. And we need to stay that way. And we're going to stay that way because we're going to see each other and we're going to keep loving each other. And I just want to tell y'all, it was the greatest time
of my life. Amen. Amen, man. Thank you, guys.
Thanks,
everyone, man.
Thank you guys.
Be good.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure to have you guys on. It just was, when we started talking about doing this, I couldn't wait. Because I feel fortunate I was a chance to cover you guys through that whole time. And the fact of the matter, when people don't know, I was close friends with all of you. I enjoyed being around all of it. And I feel like I just was able to come through all of that, watching you guys, the best of the best, play every single week and sort of being like, it's almost like we all went to school together, but I played football and y'all played basketball. One of the things that,
because you accepted me. Played another sport.
You accepted me. As a board at that point, and the fact that I was a much better athlete than you, Carl. So, so anyway, let's keep this going. Let's do it again, man.
Let's take this show on the road. We gotta take this on the road.
We'd have a good time. Hey, man, peace, brothers. Y'all be safe, and thank you very much.